हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अवर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ अल्कोहल्स, फिनॉल्स एंड ईथर। इन लास्ट सेशंस वी कंप्लीटेड अप टू 11.7 एंड टुडे वी स्टार्ट्स विथ अवर जर्नी फ्रॉम 11.8। द क्वेश्चंस इज आस्क्ड लाइक दैट, व्हाइल सेपरेटिंग अ मिक्सचर ऑफ ओर्थो एंड पैरानाइट्रोफिनॉल्स बाय स्टीम डिस्टिलेशन प्रोसेस, name the isomer which will be steam volatile and give the reasons. So orthonitrophenol is a steam volatile, we know that, because due to chelation, or sometimes it's called as an intramolecular hydrogen bonding, hence can be separated by a steam distillation from para-nitrophenol. Because para-nitrophenol is not a steam volatile due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So it's a simple, the orthonitrophenol shows lower boiling point than para-nitrophenol because of intramolecular hydrogen bond in the former case. So orthonitrophenol will be steam volatile, and the molecules of para-nitrophenols are strongly associated with the intermolecular hydrogen bond, so as a result of which it shows a higher boiling point. So maybe these questions may be asked in 1 marks or 2 marks, so we give the sufficient explanations. Now next question is, give the equations of the reactions for the preparations of phenol from cumene. So we want to prepare a phenol from cumene because this process is called as a cumene process. We all know that when the cumene is reacted with oxygen, right, with the help of 5% sodium carbonate solution, so we get a, because there is a presence of oxygen between this C and H, so it's converted into cumene hydroperoxide. And now this cumene hydroperoxide, when acidified with water, or it's a simple hydrolysis, so we get a product phenol, and acetone is a very good solvent that can be is our byproduct or side product too. So this is the reactions. Okay, next question is given like that, number 10. Okay, so number 10 questions, write a chemical reactions for the preparations of phenol from chlorobenzene. So we know that it's a down process. First we have to convert chlorobenzene with the help of NaOH. This NaOH is 6 to 8% concentrated, 360 degree centigrade temperature and 300 atmospheric pressure. So first is converted into sodium phenoxide, and now this sodium phenoxide, which can be acidified with the help of hydrochloric acid, so it's converted into phenol. But we know that this process is a historical process, which is because it's required a more amount of pressure, much higher temperature, and sometimes there is a problem because there is a side derivatives or byproduct diphenyl ether, which is also decrease the amount of phenol. So this process is now not that much used nowadays in industries. Best process is the cumene process. Number 11, write the mechanism of a hydration of ethene to yield ethanol, that already given in your book. First ethene is reacted with H plus, so is converted into ethyl carbocation, and this ethyl carbocation is react with a sulfuric acid, so it's called as an ethyl hydrogen sulfate, and this ethyl hydrogen sulfate further reacts with water, okay, and it's converted into ethanol. So it's a direct addition of water to ethene in presence of acid does not occur in this process. Indirectly, ethene is first passed through a concentrated H2SO4 when ethyl hydrogen sulfate is formed. So write the mechanism of a hydration of ethene to the yield ethanol. There are two processes, direct hydration and indirect hydration. Next question is given like that. You are given benzene, concentrated H2SO4 and NaOH. Write the equations for the preparations of phenol using these reagents. No problem. First, we have take a benzene, concentrated H2SO4. Okay, near about 80 degree centigrade temperature is required. It's a sulfonation process, and this SO3H plus is an electrophile which can be attracted towards the pi cloud of this benzene, and we get a benzene sulfonic acid. Now this benzene sulfonic acid is fused with NaOH, at near about 300 degree centigrade temperature and then acidified, so it's converted into phenol. Number 13 questions is little bit interesting and we have to focus on them. So how will you synthesize? What we have to synthesize? One phenyl ethanol. So first we have to draw the structure of one phenyl ethanol from alkene. So it's mandatory. यहाँ पे क्या है? CHCA3OH है, तो ये अल्कोहल सेकेंडरी है. यस, OH कनेक्टेड कार्बन इज सेकेंडरी, तो हमें सेकेंडरी अल्कोहल बनाना है. सो सेकेंडरी अल्कोहल के लिए हमें ये रिंग है, तो रिंग तो डालनी ही पड़ेगी. लेकिन यहाँ पे हम क्या करेंगे? CH डबल बॉन्ड CH2 लगाएंगे. और मार्कोनिको रूल की तरफ से हम देखें तो यहाँ पे कहा क्या है, दोनों C डबल बॉन्ड है, लेकिन यहाँ पे लेस नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन है. सो ओवर OH इज मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव पोर्शन इज अटैच विद द लेसर नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन कंटेनिंग कार्बन, सो वी गेट अ वन फिनाइल इथेनॉल. सो अवर कंपाउंड इज कॉल्ड एज एन, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज एन, नो नो, द नेम द हियर द नेम इज रॉन्ग, द नेम इज इथिनाइल बेंजीन, और अदर नेम इज स्टाइरीन, पेट नेम इज स्टाइरीन. And name is ethinyl benzene. Okay, it's converted into one phenyl ethanol. Next, number 2, cyclohexyl methanol using alkyl halide and SN2 mechanism. Okay, so how will you synthesize cyclohexyl methanol? I want to prepare a cyclohexyl methanol. Once again, I want to prepare cyclohexyl methanol with the help of SN2 mechanism, because this cyclohexyl methanol is a primary one, so definitely it's conducted with the SN2 mechanism, and it's a replacement of chlorine with NaOH, so it's a cyclohexyl methyl chloride or methyl bromide, whatever. If you take a chloride or bromide, no problem. Okay. Number three. What they given in number 3? Pentane 1-ol using suitable alkyl halide. I want to prepare pentane 1-ol with a suitable, so simple 1-chloropentane. If you take a 1-chloropentane, simply displacement or substitution reaction with OH, because this is primary nature, so this hydrolysis phenomena which can be governed with the help of SN2 mechanism. So this is all about the question number 11.13. Now we move to the another question is 11.14. So what they given in 11.14? So once again, the question is asked like that. Okay, give two reactions, show the acidic nature of phenol, compare acidity of phenol with that of ethanol. तो हम क्या इसमें कर सकते हैं? यहाँ पे तो ऐसा लिखा हुआ है C for answer, right? हम क्या करेंगे? जैसे फर्स्ट रिएक्शन से उसका फिनोल का सोडियम के साथ हमने किया हुआ था. फिनोल व्हेन रिएक्ट्स विद अ सोडियम, एक्टिव मेटल्स लाइक सोडियम एंड इट्स लिबरेट हाइड्रोजन गैस एंड कन्वर्टेड इनटू सोडियम फिनोक्साइड. अनदर थ्री रिएक्शंस इज फिनोल व्हेन रिएक्ट्स विद NaOH2, बिकॉज फिनोल इज डिसॉल्व इन NaOH एंड कन्वर्टेड इनटू सोडियम फिनोक्साइड. सो दिस टू रिएक्शंस विच शोस द एसिडिक नेचर ऑफ फिनोल. समटाइम फिनोल इज ऑल्सो रिएक्ट्स विद KOH or whatever the strong base. Fine. Next, explain why is orthonitrophenol is more acidic than orthomethoxyphenol. Orthonitrophenol is more acidic than orthomethylphenol. Okay. We know that the acidic property of phenol is arise from the loss of hydrogen of OH group of phenol as a H+. ये जो हम बता रहे हैं orthonitrophenol में, तो उसका जो H+ निकलेगा तो ही उसकी acidity होगी, right? So we know that this loss is favored if the polarity of the OH bond increase and hydrogen becomes more electropositive. The presence of electron withdrawing group such as nitro group increase the polarity of OH bond and thus the acidic strength of phenol is raised, because nitro क्या कर रहा है, इलेक्ट्रॉन उसको विड्रॉ कर रहा है, तो उससे क्या होगा, यहां से O से विड्रॉ हो जाएगा तो H का डेल्टा प्लस नेचर वो ज्यादा हो जाएगा, सो वो एसिडिक हो जाएगा. ओके, ऑन द कॉन्ट्रारी OCH3 इज एन इलेक्ट्रॉन रिलीजिंग ग्रुप है, वो क्या है, इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनेटिंग ग्रुप है. सो एनी इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनेटिंग ग्रुप हु डोनेट्स द इलेक्ट्रॉन टू द फिनाइल रिंग, सो डेफिनेटली दे डिक्रीज द पोलैरिटी ऑफ OH बॉन्ड एंड दस मेक्स द रिलीज ऑफ H प्लस इज डिफिकल्ट. सो दिस कैन बी अंडरस्टूड बाय द रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर. सो दे गिव सच अ टाइप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर. यहाँ पे क्या है कि जैसे ऑर्थोनाइट्रोफिनॉल है, हम इसको थोड़ा अभी मेरी स्टाइल से मैं थोड़ा आपको समझाना चाहता हूँ. ये क्या हो गया नाइट्रो में, ये एच है बिकॉज नाइट्रो इज इलेक्ट्रॉन विदड्रॉइंग ग्रुप, राइट. सो ये जो इलेक्ट्रो इंडक्टिव इफेक्ट है वो माइनस आई इफेक्ट है, माइनस इंडक्टिव इफेक्ट है. ओके सो और उसका रेजोनेटिंग इफेक्ट भी क्या है, माइनस ही है. सो दोनों माइनस की वजह से वो क्या होगा कि OHNO2 में ये डबल बॉन्ड का जो हमने सिचुएशंस देखा हुआ है, सो दे हैविंग अ लॉन पेयर, बिकॉज दे हैविंग अ लॉन पेयर. ओके सो लॉन पेयर अब यहाँ पे डोनेट हो जाएगा. सो उसकी वजह से हम अलग अलग हमारा जो है वो उसका रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर हम देख पाएंगे. तो इससे यहां से H प्लस जो निकलने की जो प्रोबेबिलिटी थी वो बिल्कुल कम हो गई है. वेल इन द केस ऑफ OCH3 है यहाँ पे, तो OCH3 में क्या होता है कि जैसे हम सोच रहे हैं कि दिस इज OCH3 ग्रुप, डेफिनेटली दे हैविंग अ प्लस आर इफेक्ट बिकॉज दे आर द इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनेटिंग ग्रुप. एनी इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनेटिंग ग्रुप डेफिनेटली दे इंक्रीज द बेसिसिटी एंड डिक्रीज द एसिडिटी. ओके सो हम इस तरह से भी सोच सकते हैं कि यहाँ पे जो OH का जो पिक्चर है तो वो H की तरफ वो ज्यादा चला जाएगा तो वो दे सकता है. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन मेरा है, एक्सप्लेन हाउ डज द OH ग्रुप अटैच टू अ कार्बन ऑफ बेंजीन रिंग एक्टिवेट इट टूवर्ड्स द इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शंस. वंस अगेन, एक्सप्लेन हाउ डज द OH ग्रुप अटैच टू अ कार्बन ऑफ अ बेंजीन रिंग एक्टिवेट इट टूवर्ड्स टू द इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन. सिंपली है OH है वो इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनेटिंग ग्रुप है, तो the OH group is an electron releasing group or electron donating. It increases the electron density with the resonating structure at ortho and para positions through resonance. So the electrophiles being an electron deficient in nature and they attacks the ring at the electron high density region like ortho and para positions. That's the reason that OH group of benzene activates the ring towards to the electrophilic substitutions reactions. Once again, phenol may be regarded as a resonant hybrid of this 1,2,5 structure which is shown in the figure. As a result, plus R effect of the OH group, the electron density in the benzene ring increase, thereby facilitating the attack by an electrophile. In other words, presence of OH group activates the benzene ring towards to the electrophilic substitution reactions, and electron density is relatively higher at the two position, ortho and one para positions. Therefore, electrophilic substitutions occurs mainly at ortho and para positions. So, these are the excellent explanations. Now, we move to the number 17th questions. It's a very good questions. May be asked in examinations too. Give equations of the following reactions. We want to prepare oxidations of propane 1-ol, oxidations of propane 1-ol with alkaline KMnO4 solutions. So what we have to do in this case, propane 1-ol when reacts with alkaline KMnO4, this is the oxidation reaction. Mind when this is primary alcohol. So this primary alcohol, firstly, it's converted into CH3CH2, COOK, and then acidified with a H plus and H2O, so it's converted into propanoic acid. So simple primary alcohol is converted into carboxylic acid. Next, bromine in carbon disulfide with phenol. We know that bromine in CH2 is a non-polar in nature, right? So when bromine, so it means that polarity of bromine is decreasing, so only mono substitutions can take place and we get a two different product, but major product is para bromo phenol and minor product is ortho bromo phenol. What about the next one, the nitrations of phenol? So nitrations of phenol gives a ortho nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. So with the help of this dilute HNO3, we have to take a dilute HNO3, so we get a product ortho nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. What we have to observe when a tetrene phenol with a chloroform in presence of aqueous NaOH, we know that this is nothing but it's a one type of Riemer-Tiemann reactions. So first OH when chloroform in presence of NaOH near about 340 Kelvin temperature is required. So it's firstly it's converted into ONaCHO and then further acidified means H plus and H2O. So it's converted into salicylaldehyde. So today we stop at here up to 17 questions. Next sessions we starts with a question number 18. Thank you very much.